tries completely, then its grip is good and strong. There you go, good as new, through and through, cause the glue won't let go. That's mechanical locking, but glue also works on a molecular level. Atoms make up everything, that's the rule. Though they're tiny, not very large, and they combine into clusters called molecules, which often can have an electric charge. Those have a couple of different ends, positive and negative too. And when opposing ends line up, they stick to each other like pairs of magnets do. It's true! There's a name for that, van der Waals forces. Now the molecules of glue are clinging by the millions to the things you're joining. So it helps them stick together.
That's the coolest thing I've ever seen.
Glue can work in many ways. I've shown you only two. But when you build a model truck or fix a handle on a cup, just think of all the
you sure know your glue. Well, better give Mr. Wonderful his answer. Thanks a lot, man.
No problem, Bang. Anytime.
Take care, brother. See ya. Bye.
See you later. Take care. Goodbye. Oh, darn. It's broken. Guess I gotta fix it again. Woo-hoo-hoo!
Welcome, class. There are two primary theories that explain how glue sticks things together, which my assistant Gopher will help me demonstrate. The first theory is called mechanical locking. Even the smoothest looking surfaces are rough when you put them under a microscope. Mechanical locking happens when wet glue pours into all of the small crevices and dries. It grips the microscopic rough surfaces and holds them together. The second theory is called van der Waals forces. It claims that things stick together at the molecular level. Molecules are groups of atoms. Some of them have positive charges, and some of them have negative charges.